Good morning. Myself, I am Mr. M. Kumarishan, guest lecturer, Department of Sports Management, TNPSU. Now, my topic is supply. Generally, supply is an economic term that refers to amount of given product or service that the suppliers are willing to offer to consumer at given level price at given period. Generally, supply notes mean we are ready to deliver the finished goods to the consumer at given level price to the consumer in the market. Economical supply means when the price of the product is low, the supply is low. When the price of the product is high, the supply is high. The statements note that like that, the price of the product, if it is high now, we will make the manufacturers earn more and more. If it is price of the product, if it is low, if demand is level is low, the customers not willing to purchase the product at the time of. So the supply of the product will be increased. So the economical supply notes mean that when the demand and price of the product is high now, at the time the supply of the product will be high. When the supply of the product is low, it means the price of the product is low. Okay. The next slide is the determinants of the supply. Determinants of the supply also note that are the factors which influence the quantity of the product or supply supplied. The price of the product is major factor affecting the willingness and ability to supply. Here we will discuss the determinants of supply other than the price. You know, generally we discuss the basic concept will depends on price, because when you identify the price of the product, you automatically choose the supply level of the product. So other than the price, what are the determinants will affect the supply level of the product? The first one, number of sellers, and second one, price of the resources, and third one, tax and subsidies, fourth one, technology, fifth one, supplier's expectation, sixth one, price of related products, last one, price of joint products. So now we'll share the information. First one, numbers of sellers. Numbers of sellers, the greater the number of sellers is, greater will be quantity of the product or service supplied in market and vice versa. For example, when more firms enter an industry, the number of sellers increase, thus increasing the supply. Because if it like the price of the product is low, sorry, the price of the product is high, that supply level, the demand level of the product is also high. So at that time, everyone will start to manufacture the product and sell the product and supply to the consumers. So based on the number of sellers, if it is number of sellers is more than available in the market, now the supply of the product automatically increased. Next level, price of resources. Increase in resource prices increase the production cost, thus shrinking the profit and vice versa. Since the profit is the major incentive for producers to supply goods and service, increase in profit increase the supply and decrease in profit reduce the supply. In other words, supply is indirectly proportional to resource prices. Increase in resource prices reduce the supply, whereas decrease in resource prices increase the supply. So in the topic, in the price of resources, if you like that, if we go to manufacture the product now, we need the raw materials like man, machinery, manpower, materials. So these are comes to the main raw materials. If it is the raw materials cost will be high now, the supply level we automatically decreased. If it is supply level, if it is raw material cost will be low now, we will increase the supply level. So based on price of the resources, raw materials, like raw materials, if it is based on the cost of raw materials, we will increase or decrease the supply level of the product. Then next, technology. The improvement in technology enables more efficient and production of goods and services, thus reducing the production cost and increasing the profit. Since technology generally rarely deteriorates, therefore it is needless to say that deterioration of technology reduces the supply. So nowadays everyone using the new updated technology machineries in the manufacturing department. If it is, we can use the new updated manufacturing departments now, we can easily to manufacture and produce the product. So if it is new updated technology materials, if we use, we can easily generate more and more production of products. So when the production is will be high, now automatically the supply level will be high. So based on the technology, the main important will generate more and more supply of the product or services to the consumers. Next, tax and subsidies. Tax reduce the profits, therefore increase in taxes reduce the supply, whereas decrease in taxes increase the supply. Subsidies are reduce the burden of a production cost on suppliers, thus increase the profits. So therefore, increase in subsidies increase the supply, decrease in supply decrease the supply. So first you can understand what is with tax, what is with subsidies. Tax, na, if you're going to buy any raw materials, any machineries, so at the time we could pay some additional amount tax. The tax maybe depends on the state and central level. Nowadays we are paying the GST, goods and service tax. So the tax level of the product will be high, na, we can automatically the production level is will decrease out. Maybe it will be decreased. So tax reduce the profit, therefore increase in tax now reduce the supply, because the tax level of the raw materials and whatever things we can use the productions, so will be the tax will increase, now we can reduce the productions. So at the time supply will automatically reduce. When the tax level is low, now we automatically increase the productions and supply level of the product will be increased. The next, subsidies is like that, concessions. So the government will give you some concessions to the some industry, some product manufacturers. Okay, so likewise, generally the government will give a free current service to the farmers because they are manufacturing the food items. Same like us, the subsidies will be main important. If it is subsidy available, subsidies if it is increased, now we can increase the automatically increase the supply level of the product. If it is subsidies decrease, now will decrease the supply of the product, because subsidies will give the increase, give the more and more level, huh? We automatically generate the productions. Okay, if it is production level increased, now automatically supply level increased. The next term is supplier expertise. Supplier expertise main important. Like that, the supplier expertise based on the based on the some period of time, you know, likewise, if just leave the explanation, change in expectation of suppliers about future price of the product or service may affect their current supply. First is the first line, change in expectation of suppliers about the future price of product or service may affect their current supply. If it is, for example, I am supplying some goods to the consumer, now these goods will be get the more price in future, like after 2 months, after 1 year. So at the time I will, so now I would not sell the product, I would not supply the product to consumer. So I will hold all the product. So I will hold the product after 1 year, after 2 years, I will supply the product to consumer. Because I know the idea, I get the information after 2 months, after 1 year, the price of the product will increase. The same it comes to the supply expectation. Okay, however, unlike the other determinants of supply, the effect of supply expectation on supply is difficult to generalize. For example, when farmers expect the future price of the crop to increase, so they will withhold the agriculture producers to benefit from higher price, thus reducing the supply. In case of manufacturers, when they expect the future price to increase, they will employ more resources to increase the output and they may increase the current supply as well. Okay. The next point is price of related goods. The farms which are able to manufacture related products such as air conditioners, refrigerators, will they shift their production to a product the price of which increase substantially related to other related products, thus causing a reduction of supply of other product which were produced before. For example, just an example, a farm which produced the cricket bats is usually able to manufacture the hockey sticks as well. Okay, when the price of hockey sticks increase, the farm will produce more hockey sticks and less cricket bats. So as a result, the supply of cricket bats will be reduced. Price of related goods, for example, you are going to manage the two products like cricket bat and hockey stick. So now currently in the market, the need of the hockey stick is demand is very high. So you are fully focused to manufacture the hockey stick only and give them less important, less manufacturers of the cricket bat only. So because the need, the demand of the product as well as the price line of the product. If it is the cricket bat, the likeness amount is 200, but hockey stick 1000. So at the time, the hockey stick 1000, everyone ready to buy the hockey stick. At that time, you are fully focused to manufacture the hockey stick only. So the price of related goods will define the supply level of the product. Last one is price of joint products. When two or more goods are produced in a joint process and the price of any of the product increase, the supply level of all the joint products will be increased and vice versa. For example, increase in price of the meat will increase the supply of leather. So the prices of joint products, now you are producing or manufacturing two products. So one product level of the demand, level of price increase in the market. Now automatically it depends on other products also. You will get the more price and more level of demand in the market. So the price of the joint products is the main important to identify the supply level of the product. It means, for the example, increase the price of the meat now, automatically increase the supply of leather. Okay. So these are comes under the determinants of the supply, how to identify the supply level of the product. So these things are comes under the determinants of supply. Okay. So today we discussed about what is mean supply and determinants of supply. Thank you.